Everyone got quiet all of a sudden, waiting for the big moment. I'm Father Randy Hunt. I'm pastor here at St. Margaret's, and I want to welcome all of you to this wonderful ceremony between Collin and Alexandria, and to thank our minister of music, Professor Brockington, for providing a musical accompaniment for this great event, and yourselves for following the protocol of wearing face coverings and social distancing. Even though it's challenging at this time, it's for the best all around. And I want to take a moment to ask you to check your cell phones and have them turned off during our worship time so as not to be interrupted. And we will begin very soon with seating of the VIP people, the grandparents, and then we'll begin with our procession. So welcome everybody to this wonderful day.
Thank you.
Please remain standing. Even though you're probably tired from enjoying their wedding procession, but we're finally all here. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of Jesus Christ, and our communion in the Spirit be with you all. Thank you. The Spirit of God's love is truly present with us today as we look to the outside and see the springtime coming alive, and as we look inside and see the springtime of Collin and Alexandria's life beginning in a new way. Let us pray now. Loving God, you have made us in your image and likeness, male and female, and you call us to be one as you, God, are one. Bless this couple as they walk the path that leads them to eternal life, knowing the joys of marriage along the way. And we pray for their families who have brought them this far by faith, hope, and love. We pray this in the name of your Son, Jesus, who teaches us that giving of ourselves is the best way to love, and that finding ourselves we find in giving ourselves. We pray this in the name of your Son, Jesus, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God with us forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us be seated now for the Word of God. And our first greeting will be read by Josh Lupperton.
A reading from the Book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah rose and from bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and grant us deliverance." Sarah got up, and they started to pray and beg deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God, our Father. Praised be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam, and you gave him his wife Eve to help and support him. And from these two, the human race descended. You said, 'It is not good for a man to be alone. Let us make him a partner for like himself.' Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife not because of lust, but because of a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and on her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." They said together, "Amen, amen." The word of the Lord.
Just stop there. Our next scripture will be proclaimed by Lindsay Cock Bernacki, cousin of the bride.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Jesus said, from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you,
You're not wearing masks today because you're the bride and the groom, so you're given a special exemption. Also, there's a story in the Bible, you might remember it, where Jacob was supposed to marry Rachel, and the father of the Rachel substituted another daughter and put a veil over her face so that Jacob didn't know that he was really having intimacy with Leah instead of Rachel. And so he was kind of put into the position where he had to wait 7 more years to marry Rachel. And the father, in a devious way, kept putting it off. So we wanted you to see each other face to face and know that the person you're marrying is the one that you plan to marry. We hear of destination weddings, and we know that sometimes people choose exotic places by the seashore or by the lake or on a mountaintop, but they never really have much familiarity with those places. They just do it for a once-in-a-lifetime, good picture place. But you have a destination wedding today in a place that's already familiar to you. You've been members of St. Margaret's for some time, and this destination is more important to you than a beautiful outdoor scenery. It's not a bad-looking church anyway. And your destination is really beyond today. It's to get each other to the eternal kingdom of heaven through love. We have a mission statement at St. Margaret's that I think fits just about every human situation. It starts off like this. Put God first. Start with prayer. Invite, welcome, embrace, work and grow in Christ. And that's a good mission statement for anybody, especially for yourselves, because you're already doing it. You've already started with God. You already start with prayer, as you had in your first scripture reading from Tobit, where they began their wedding night with prayer. And you have invited and welcomed each other into your life. You've known each other for about 10 years now, so it's not like you're strangers at all. And you're going to work and grow in Christ. Some cynics say that marriage is not a good way to go, and they will talk about the three rings of marriage. They'll talk about the engagement ring, the wedding ring, and suffering. But I think they're wrong. I'd like to add another ring to that, the offering of yourselves to each other in a way that's truly complete and special. And Alexandria, I knew you before you were even born, in a way. My family used to frequent the Eastern Market because they were farmers not far from here, and we would sell our produce there. And that's how Ali, your grandparents, met each other, Marion and Paul, on the Eastern Market. Your grandfather was a buyer, and she was a seller. And I guess when he saw her, he saw more than the pansies that they offered. And he bought what she had, and he bought her for the rest of his life. And our family also met, my parents met on the Eastern Market, and they had the early morning route to go, like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, so the woman couldn't put much makeup on then. What you saw was what you got. And, you have come together in your own unique way now, and over the years you've shown your love for each other by your commitment, by your patient waiting, and by your giving of yourselves in the patient way that is so important in love. I guess, Collin, at one time you drove 18 hours to come to Alexandria's graduation, and you drove 16 hours to get back, so that's truly love, isn't it? And that's a commitment that you started some time ago, and now you're going to take each other along life's journey in a special way. Some time ago, when I was getting ready for a wedding here at St. Margaret's, as I put on my socks in the morning, I noticed that they had on them the label, Darn Tough. That's a special brand of socks. And I said, that's a good word to give to people when they get married. So since then, I always provide a pair of socks for the couple. Once I learn your size, I'll be getting you a pair of Darn Tough socks. So when you put your socks on in the morning, you can know that no matter how darn tough life can be, you're still going to walk in Christ with those socks on and with your love for each other. So today, we go to the scriptures where it said, Tobit and his wife, they began with these words, Blessed are you, O God of our fathers, praise be your name forever and ever. Let heaven and all your creation praise you forever. And so I know you begin your day and your life with praising God and thanking God for the partner that God has given you. And in the very frequent used but very special scripture from Paul's letter to the Corinthians, it speaks about the power of love to change us.
Love is patient, love is kind, it is not jealous, it is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude, it does not seek its own interest, it is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury, it does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. So you have demonstrated that love for each other in the truth of your lives, and I like to think of marriage as anticipation, celebration, and validation or dedication, that you have anticipated this day with great desire to do it correctly and to have everything in place, and everything will fall into place this day. You're in the process of celebrating your love now, and your dedication will bring out the greatest love that you can have. Collin, last Sunday, when we had a session with those who were initiated into the church, because Collin had not completed his sacraments, but he did this year very faithfully, you were given a book called Living Your Strengths. And this is a book that is designed to help people know what their strengths are for serving the Lord. And it describes a strength in this way. A strength is the ability to provide consistent, near-perfect performance in a given activity. This ability is a powerful, productive combination of talent, skill, and knowledge. So you have now entered a relationship where sometimes people in marriage point each other's weaknesses out and they dwell on them. But marriage is really about bringing out the strength of the other person and to help that strength bond them even stronger. So as you come to know your strengths in the church and in your marriage, you will make our world a better place. God bless you, and you have our prayers with you. Please come forward. Collin O'Connell of Alexandria. Alan, you've come together in the house of the church in the presence of myself and this community. Your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that you may be faithful to each other and assume all the responsibilities and the joys of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intention. Collin and Alexandria, have you come here freely and without hesitation to enter into the sacrament of marriage?
Yes.
Yes.
Are you prepared to follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
Yes.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church, the law of love?
Yes.
Yes.
And I'll ask the congregation a yes question, at least the answer is yes. Do you promise that as you have known and loved this couple throughout their lives together, you will continue to support them and to pray for them and love them throughout their married life together? On three. One, two, three.
Yes.
That's a lot of support. Since it is your intention to enter into the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands now and declare your consent before God and His church. I, Collin.
I, Collin.
Take you, Alexandria.
Take you, Alexandria.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All my days of my life.
I, Alexandria.
I, Alexandria. Alexandria.
Take you, Collin.
Take you, Collin.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
May the God of Abraham and Sarah, the God of Isaac and Rachel, the God of Jacob, the God who joined together our first parents in paradise, strengthen and bless in Christ the consent you have declared before the church, so that what God joins together, no one must separate. Lord, bless these rings which Collin and Alexandria will now exchange with one another. May the circle of these rings be as the circle of your love, with beginning and ending joined together in that eternal symbol of love. We pray this in the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Take a ring. Look at your beautiful bride. Alexandria, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Look at your handsome husband. Collin, take this ring.
Collin, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
You've declared your consent before God and God's people. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with many blessings. For what God has joined together, no one must separate. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Once more. Amen.
Amen.
This should be sealed with a kiss. I think you practiced that before. Now we have the unity candle.
Promise to pray for you. We're going to begin that right now with our prayers of the faithful. Denise Wood is going to lead us in these prayers. Please stand.
The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who lead us in the ways of faith, hope, and love, may they be faithful in their ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our government leaders, may they help to build society where the rights and dignity of all people are respected. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married couples, may they find the challenge of love to be a blessing and the rewards of love to be a gift for others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Collin and Alexandria, now beginning and yet continuing their lives together, may they find their life and their love in Christ to increase their joy and renew their gratitude for all the good gifts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle in the ways of love, may they find guidance from the gospel of Christ and wisdom in their efforts to learn the ways of new beginnings. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those who care for them, for healing in body, mind, and spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, Paul and Marion Ellman, Roland Burke, Ruth Bolton, Bill Cox, Bill Myers, Theodore Garung, and Raphael Garung, may their spirit be with us, especially the deceased members of the families of Collin and Alexandria. May the risen Lord always unite us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For any unspoken intentions, we pause in a moment of silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And through these prayers, Lord, strengthen the bond of love between this man and this woman, between all of us as we strive to live the resurrection of Jesus Christ in our daily lives. We pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated now as we come to the table of the Lord.
Thank you.
Please pray now, sisters and brothers, that these our gifts will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Loving God, may the offering of these simple gifts of bread and wine, formed from our farms and our fields and shaped by human hands, transformed now by the power of your love into the very life of Jesus Christ, be the transformation that transforms Collin and Alexandria into husband and wife in the sacrament of your love, which will last forever. We pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. It is our duty, our joy, and our salvation at all times to praise and thank you, Father of mercy, faithful God. For at the very dawn of creation, you made us male and female and called us to be one as you, God, are one. For love is our origin. Love is our constant calling. Love is our fulfillment. And the love of a man and woman is made holy in the sacrament of marriage and becomes for us a reflection of your everlasting love. This fills us with gratitude and great joy as we lift our hearts and our voices now with angels and saints proclaiming this hymn of praise. You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the font of all holiness. Let your Spirit now come upon these gifts to make them holy like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and yet willingly entered into his passion, because he loved us, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Jesus' death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here at your table in your presence, ministering to you, our God. Humbly we pray that by the very sharing of the body and blood of Christ, we may all be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church gathered here and spread throughout the world. Bring us all to the fullness of charity as we pray now in communion with Francis, our Pope, Alan, our bishop, and all those who love, who lead, who serve, and shepherd your entire people, especially those who are married and witness to the sacrament of your divine love. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have died, those who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. For all who have died in your mercy, Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that in communion with Mary, the Blessed Virgin Mother of God, and with Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, all of our patron saints, St. Margaret, Blessed Father Solanus Casey, Blessed Father Mychael McGivney, and with all the saints who have served you throughout the ages, we may merit ourselves to be co-heirs to eternal life, praising you, glorifying you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus gave his life for us in the same way that Collin and Alexandria are given their lives to each other. And so we pray to the Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Colin and Alexandria, this Bible has been given to you by St. Margaret's as a fixture for your home. As I mentioned when we met, if you wear it out, we'll replace it free. And we're going to pray this blessing over you now. I'd ask if the maid of honor could stand next to the bride and the best man next to the groom. Put your hands on their shoulders. And if the congregation would like to extend their hands in blessing as I pray this wedding blessing for the bride and groom. Colin and Alexandria, may your children bring you happiness, and may your generous love for them be returned to you many times over. May the peace of Christ live always in your hearts and in your home. May you have true friends to stand by you, both in joy and in sorrow. May you be ready and willing to help and comfort those who come to you in need. And may the blessings promised through the compassionate be yours in abundance. May you find happiness and satisfaction in your work. May daily problems never cause you undue anxiety, nor the desire for earthly possessions ever dominate your lives. But may your heart's first desire always to be the good things that you can do for each other and for others, and the joy waiting for you in the life of heaven. May the Lord bless you with many happy years together, that you may enjoy the rewards of a long life. And after you have served God loyally in his kingdom on earth, may he welcome you to his eternal kingdom in heaven. We pray this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and gratefully, joyfully offer and bless those who have gathered here with the peace of Christ that lives beyond our understanding. May the peace of Christ be with you always. I invite you to turn to those around you and offer them a simple gesture of our peace in Christ.
Sharing Holy Communion, we'll have two communion stations. I invite you to go to the one that's most convenient, the most proximate for you. If you have difficulty coming forward, please let us know and I'll come to you in the congregation. For this is our time of communion with God and with each other, but also with Collin and Alexandria. For at the table of the Lord, we are truly one, both in heaven and on earth. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. Congregation may be seated until you come forward to share this sacrament.
Just for you, intended only for your eyes.
Alexandria and Collin are now going to make a visit to the Holy Family Shrine to pray for their deceased relatives and also to ask the blessing of the Holy Family on their marriage together.
Let us pray. Lord, we have celebrated your life at this table, the life of Jesus Christ given us through his passion, death, and resurrection. We have celebrated the love and the life of Collin and Alexandria,
as they begin and yet continue their lives together. May your grace be always upon them. May their unity be a light to the world, and may they make our world a better place by the love that they show for each other and your love for them. We pray this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Collin and Alexandria, as a further gift from the parish, we present this simple cross that has two rings joined together. Pray you'll find a place in your home to remind you of this day and the rings of God's love that bind you. And there's a quote that goes with it. Matrimony, may we be open to the grace of God in this work of a lifetime. May we see each other through the eyes of our Creator who brought us together. May this sacred union help to heal and repair our world and ourselves. I'll give this to your best man to watch over and make sure you receive it later on. Please come forward now and bring your flowers. Collin and Alexandria, may God, our loving Creator, who first gave you life, who formed you in your mother's wombs, bless you and be with you all the days of your life. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
May Jesus Christ, God's Son, our brother, who himself was a guest at the wedding feast of Cana, be a guest at your daily table and at the table of the Eucharist, which you will share often. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God, the bond of love, stronger than death, keep you joined to each other all the days of your life until you come to the everlasting kingdom of God. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Before we conclude, I'd like to have some praise God's among us. So first of all, we're going to praise God for your family and your friends who came out today and joined you in this celebration. Let's praise God for them. And for the people behind the scenes, like Christine Wallasek, and all the people who helped you with your showers, and our Professor Brockington, who did such a beautiful job on the music. We praise God for those people who are in the background. And finally, we praise God for yourselves, Mr. and Mrs. Collin of Alexandria O'Connell. Praise God.